So for fans of the Toronto Red Wings, the name Paul Woods is well respected and obviously rings a bell because he's currently the color commentator on the Red Wings games on radio station 97.1 FM to Ticket. But did you know that Paul Woods was on the radar of the Montreal Canadiens long before he became captain of the Red Wings? Now, today on The Legend of Paul Woods, we're going to talk about his time as a Calder Cup champion that led him to Detroit and to be one of the best defensive forwards in the NHL at the time. Now, Paul William Woods, born April 12, 1955, in Hespelier, Ontario, spent the majority of his NHL career for Detroit between 77 and 84. Now, as a youth, like many, many players we're talking about in these podcasts, he played in the Quebec International Pee Wee Hockey Tournament. And his year was 1966 with a team from his hometown. Now, he became the major prominence with the three-year career with the legendary Sault Ste. Marie Greyhounds. His opening year in 73, he had 64 points, including 30 goals. 74, he had 49 points in 48 games. And his big breakthrough season, of course, was 1975, his draft year, when he had 38 goals, 81 assists, and 119 points. Now, Montreal were taking a strong look at him. And by the 76 season, he was sent to the Voyageurs, and that year was one of the best seasons of his career. He had 38 points, but he had great success. He scored the Calder Cup winning goal for the squad in 76, and when the Voyageurs repeated in 77, he had some good totals of 20 goals, 18 assists, and 38 points. Now, because Montreal was loaded up front with defensive players, Chartrand, Roberts, Jarvis, Gainey, technically, Trombley, Lambert, Risebrow, Rick Maher was in the mix too, and Rick was later let go. And after his two seasons in Nova Scotia, he was put on waivers when he was taken by Detroit in the 77 waiver draft. Now, his time with Detroit was outstanding, and he really blossomed. Like I said, he was the youngest captain in team history prior to Steve Yzerman. He had 19 goals in his rookie season and settled in a very quality role as a defensive forward. He would shut down some of the top players. He helped Detroit to a partially successful playoff run in 1978, where he had five assists in seven games. But because of his work ethic and because of his personality and because he wasn't scared to go into corners and face the top players, made him a fan favorite in Detroit. And when they went into their new rink later on, Paul Woods was basically somebody that the fans would cheer on and draw a lot of positive interest. Now, he finished his NHL career with 72 goals, 124 assists, with 502 games played. Now, he finished a pro career with the Red Wings affiliate Adirondack in 1984-85 with 2 goals and 11 assists for 13 points. Again, 501 career games, 72 goals, 124 assists, and 196 points. And he also had a chance to play for Team Canada in the 79 World Championships, where he skated in all 8 games. But some of us thought he was going to kind of maybe choose to go to WHA because the Toros took him 84th overall in 75, but Montreal was just too crowded. And, you know, when Montreal was giving away a rare player with a quality of Paul Woods, where he would average anywhere between, you know, 10 and 15 goals a season with some strong, you know, play on the road especially. Woods really played good at the Montreal Forum. You can look at the old tapes. Actually, he's referred to quite heavily in Ken Dryden's version of the game, which talks about a late season game they had with Detroit at the Forum. So, Paul Woods, legend in Detroit. To take a career like that, quite short, only 12, 13 seasons, but each season was quality. Each season drew a lot of interest because, you know, to be a color commentator for as long as he has, he must be good because he knows hockey. one of the smartest minds in hockey. And people don't really talk about him much, but that's why I'm doing this podcast today. Have a great evening. Bye.